This video, I show you the browser add-on ID. It's an add-on for Firefox. I already installed it, so I just activate it here. This is the user interface. And now, as long as those red button is activated, the tool will record all the steps that I'm doing in the browser. For example, I can navigate to a page. And I can do some interaction with the page, scrolling down, clicking on something, and the add-on records all the steps that I performed. And now I can run all the steps again by clicking on this button. And as you can see, it will perform the very same steps. And if a step succeeds, then it becomes green, and if it fails because the page changed, then it will become red. Now this test maybe is not that useful because I have to start it by hand, and I may can't do all the things I would like to do in it. But what I can now do is I can export the test as, in this case, Java JUnit WebDriver, giving it an arbitrary name. Now let's have a look into that. So, and this one, if I would start it, it would not work. You will see in the next video why. But this one gives a good first impression about how the test should, how a test class should look like. And I actually used that one and extended it to my own tests. So, because here is a global variable driver, that's the one that interacts with the browser. Then here's a method that's called before each test, which instantiates this driver. Then this is an actual test. It opens the URLs in the browser, then it finds some elements by some of their properties. Then it interacts with those elements, it does clicking, it sends in some keys, and so on. And after each test class, the driver is closed, the browser session is shut down, so the next test can run from a clean state. And so this is a good base to work on, and what you can do with it, you will see in the next video.